experiences through PowerPoint presentations, and they are sharing their village visit observations with us. And DG desired that the Group 1 Foundation course officers should witness the presentations on three model villages of Telangana, and hence we all have got gathered here to witness that. Okay, and a big round of applause for all layers for trainees who have undergone the biggest village visit, and we are successfully conducting the presentations since yesterday. And probably you may be having the solace today. You are done away with this by at the end of this program, and I congratulate you all for that. And we welcome Mr. Sethi and Dr. Nabi and the course director of Shriram Prasad over here, who have been there yesterday. But let me introduce them to our Group 1 Foundation course trainees also. That's the objective behind introducing Dr. Nabi and Dr. Sethi, who is Mr. Sethi. He is our chief consultant of e-learning here, and who is being additional director general at this institute earlier. And he is representing some sort of this foundation course on behalf of this Institute of Secretarial Training and Management also. So we welcome you formally to this presentation session.
This is SRSP flood canal, which is dried from the 2 years, water was not there. The most important part of the map is irrigation pond. The villagers called it Manjira Cheruvu, which water all of the part of the field actually.
अगर हम साक्षरता दर की बात करें तो गांव की लिटरेसी रेट है वो 51% है, और गांव की साक्षरता दर को बढ़ाने, लोगों को शिक्षित एवं आत्मनिर्भर बनाने के लिए साक्षर भारत अभियान के तहत बहुत ही सराहनीय कदम उठाए गए हैं। इसके तहत गांव के 182 लोगों को पढ़ने के लिए प्रेरित किया गया, जिनमें से कि 100 लोगों ने नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ ओपन स्कूलिंग के तहत एक एग्जाम पास करके साक्षर होने का प्रमाण पत्र भी प्राप्त किया है।
In short, the training is very intensive, very insightful, and especially if you want to know about the nuances of government machinery and all. And personally, I'm very happy to know about it, and the overall support, guidance and instruction from all the professors and faculty present is phenomenal. I just liked it. And that experience which we learned in the classroom, coupled with our own insights that we applied in that village attachment, I think till date it has been a perfect mix and a perfect input-output. I think it's overall it's perfect.
So the difference of culture and of course the language, I thought it would be a problem, but ever since I've been in MCR-HRD, I don't think that's been a problem at all, considering all the people here are North Indian, and otherwise English is a primary language anybody understands. So when we do go outside, it sometimes becomes a little bit of a problem, but then now we've figured out how to maneuver through it.
Coming to Hyderabad will be definitely a language problem for how will we communicate and how we will be ensuring all our daily needs and all those things. They bothered me, but coming here and living in the hostels of MCR-HRD, it has been a very nice experience. People are easy. We are also learning to some extent how could we explain our basic needs or daily needs in the local language, what people like the mess people what we are having in the people working in our hostels. So we are communicating and learning with them, so it is being a nice experience till date.
NREGA scheme was happening currently at this irrigation tank site, where desiltation of the tank is done, and the soil from the irrigation tank was being spread over the agriculture land. That will add to the fertility of the plants. And
Average waste per day is 160. Actually, it is 180 rupees per meter, but roughly it comes around 160 for the Narega workers. And this is being weekly or probably fortnightly.
I want to speak about Raitu Bandhu scheme also. See, many of us knows Raitu Bandhu scheme has 4,000 per acre per crop per season, but there is so much work on it done by the Telangana government. First, it started with the land purification of the records, LRUP. It was done from the last year of March. And then after that, after purifying the land records, they have issued new passbook, which is having 21 security features, like a unique identification number, and it is having account number, IFSC code, and the fingerprint of the farmer also. And it is a non-tampered passbook. We cannot write it with our manual pen, whatever. And then, after this, they have consolidated the data of all records in a website called Dharani website. It will be accessed by both the revenue department and also banks.
Gram Swaraj Abhiyan was conducted from 14th April to 5th of May. इस अभियान का मुख्य उद्देश्य था लोगों को सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट स्कीम के बारे में जागरूक कराना. इस अभियान के तहत कुछ 7 स्कीम्स थी जिनके बारे में लोगों को अवगत कराना था. उन 7 स्कीम्स में पहली स्कीम है उज्ज्वला योजना. उज्ज्वला योजना का मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव है लोगों को, एवरी हाउस होल्ड को विच बिलोंग्स टू बीपीएल फैमिली, उनको एलपीजी कनेक्शन प्रोवाइड कराना. और नागापुर विलेज में लगभग सभी के पास एलपीजी कनेक्शन था बिकॉज ऑफ दीपम स्कीम. दीपम इज अ स्टेट गवर्नमेंट स्कीम एंड अंडर दिस स्कीम 235 कनेक्शन हैव बीन प्रोवाइडेड एंड 56 कनेक्शंस वर ओन परचेस्ड. And out of 56, three household were not having any connection because they were single male. And this Deepam scheme and is providing LPG connection to only to women.
Earlier, I was very much skeptical about my training in Hyderabad. I mean, how I'll be able to adjust over here and how I'll be able to make new friends. But now I'm thinking it feels good to be in the South India for the first time. And if it had not been for the home posting, I would have permanently settled over here, I mean, in Hyderabad. And the most important thing I'll miss about this MCRHRD Institute is my campus. The greenery is so good over here, and the best part is the yoga session. When we come out of the yoga session, it feels so good. There are so many birds and greenery.
Since I belong to the same Telugu speaking state, I cannot find any issues here. It's a great experience. Like, although I know I'm Hyderabad and this all thing, but this is the first time entering into government institution and into this MCRHRD. It was really quite a nice experience.
Training is quite hectic sometimes, and it's actually good because people are always involved in it, and faculty is they are focusing on personality development actually. So this was not done in the previous batches also. This is the first time they're focusing on core subjects only, like noting, drafting, the office work, and plus these village attachments and other activities also. Like we had icebreaking activities also. So that is team building and strategy making. Yeah. So overall, it's good. It's actually improving you as a person.
It was great. To be very frank, prior to coming here, I was working in the income tax department investigation wing, but it was all north people over there, and most of the people were of my age. I'll be 28 this year. So when I turned up here, there were 93 people, and I think people ranging from 22 and till 20-30s also. So it's like living that phase again. So I can see a lot of people, and I can see a lot of experience coming in. Then again, coming to Hyderabad, I've never been to South for such a long period. I have visited Kerala, Tamil Nadu, but for 10 days or 15, just for a tourist purpose. But coming down here, leaving my family for such a long time was a nice experience. And overall, the institute is very good. And just thinking about that, I aspire to be a civil servant in the near future. So thinking about the fact that I'm living in the place where UPSC Foundation course also goes on. it's a good feeling.
Any one of you from rural background?
Yes.
Yes. Where are you from?
Sir, Rajasthan mein Dausa district mein ke paas kaam hai.
This all is 3 point.
3 point.
Sir, in 3 points, you can compare with your village and the village where you live.
सर सबसे मेन पॉइंट जो भागीरथा जो मिशन चल रहा है वो एक तरीके का पहला ऐसा मिशन मतलब एक तरीके का पहला ऐसा प्रोग्राम है जो तेलंगाना में चलाया जा रहा है क्योंकि इतने बड़े स्तर पर सभी को हर एक इंडिविजुअल घर को पीने का पानी प्रोवाइड करना कोई आसान काम नहीं है लेकिन अगर मैं राजस्थान से कंपेयर करूँ तो वहाँ का वहाँ की भौगोलिक परिस्थितियाँ कुछ भिन्न है यहाँ पर दो नदियाँ बहती हैं और वहाँ पर ऐसा कुछ नहीं है कि हम हर एक किसी को वो जो पानी प्रोवाइड कर सकें लेकिन एक दो तीन चीज़ें हैं जो राजस्थान सरकार तेलंगाना गवर्नमेंट से सीख सकती है सबसे पहली बात तो जो रायतु बंधु स्कीम है उसके अंदर डिजिटल करण पट्टे का वो किस सिक्योरिटी फीचर्स के साथ है वो किया जा सकता है और किसानों को मदद दी जा सकती है जिस तरीके से यहाँ दी जाती है और दूसरा बात सर दूसरी बात है सेक्स रेशियो राजस्थान में अभी भी पढ़े लिखे लोग भी सर अभी भी वो बेटा बेटा बेटी के चक्कर में अभी भी पढ़े हुए हैं कि हाँ बेटी नहीं होनी चाहिए आनी चाहिए यहाँ पे ज़्यादातर गांव में बेटियों की महिलाओं की जो जनसंख्या है वो ज़्यादा है
I don't think much any further words are required because the kind of governance model and mechanism that we saw that is something which is unique for us coming from North India because over there political power structures hierarchies social caste every hierarchy is so entrenched and over here despite obviously the gradations are there in the society and the power structures are there but these three things combining into one beautiful output is very unique here. And the outcome was obviously every beneficiary of every scheme that we, the implementation of which we reviewed, is so happy. I mean, it is just so platonic to ask people whether in front of their leaders or otherwise, everyone is like, yes, we are happy. So it was, in fact, it was very easy for us to write down 100% coverage, 100% coverage, 100% coverage. But overall, it was a good experience.
For whatever basic necessities that I have taken for granted all my life. It just when you come to, of course, being in a place like Ganga Devi Pali, which is a model village and is already so progressive, which hardly felt like a village, like I said before. But the fact too is that understanding that people's hopes rely on you. So you know, a lot of people come into government's sector because they think it's got power and it's got good money and everything else. But the realization that you can make an impact on people's life, that was very empowering. And apart from that, just the entire because I come from a place like Pune, which is technically developed. So, you know, just realizing that there are people, there are faces behind the numbers, like somebody mentioned, that the humanization of the data, that, you know, whatever you read, you read about the farmer suicides, the farmers marching, and it doesn't feel like a big deal when you're reading about it in newspaper, because that's just black and white print. But when you are there and when you see somebody who is, when we can't even walk at 12 p.m. on the streets, and there's somebody who's there at 2 p.m., and he's plowing the land, it becomes an eye-opening feeling.
I was at the village Ganga Devi Palli. So before going to the village, we thought it will be a great language barrier for us because we were deputed there to communicate with the local people, not the authorities, because authorities will frame a different picture and the picture will be something different in the minds of people. So we are there to communicate with the people. We faced a lot of problems, but I give a remark to the village. The kids there were so talented. Even a kid of 5th or 6th class, he could speak that much fluent English. So we took them with us and they cannot fabricate things. They will just translate what we say and what the other person say. So it was the biggest advantage with what we got in Ganga Devi Palli. Otherwise, I would have found it very difficult, but due to that, we found it easy and it was very easy. So we listened to the problems of people. We took kids with us. We offered, we'll feed you, but you just help us. So it was very nice experience. Kids were also very nice. They never denied that we'll not come. So it was like eye-opening for us, and the kids I don't know, but they are very talented. They must get some higher education and good education, I hope.
People in South India are very much innocent as compared to the people in North India. And the village we had visited was Takalpally, and the people over there were very warm and welcoming. And what I have observed is that the people from that the villages in South India are comparatively better than the villages in North India. Actually, there is 24/7 electricity supply. Even in our cities, just forget about the villages. Even in our cities, there is nowhere 24/7 electricity supply. There are pakka roads. So many schemes are going on, and they are very well implemented by the government.
It comes under Warangal urban district. It is it is situated at roughly 25 kilometers from Warangal, and it's a very big village. It's spread around in 4,113.36 acres. And the most important thing about this village is it is famous for its Mulkanur Cooperative Rural Development Bank and Marketing Limited and Mulkanur Women's Cooperative Dairy. So this cooperative, rural bank, cooperative and marketing society is Asia's most successful cooperative. And it has been awarded many a times, and many foreign dignitaries visit it often. And same goes for Women's Mulkanur Cooperative Dairy as well.
The scheme that have been initiated for supporting farmers, first one is Mission Kakatiya. This is a program for rejuvenating all the minor irrigation tanks as well as to serve the irrigation water needs of farmers. The tanks and lakes are dug to remove silt for improving for increasing water storage capacity. Under this scheme, 6 kuntas have been dug so far, but this desiltation process is still going on there.
Undertook the seasonal analysis under which we compared the different seasons, summer, rainy, and the district's harvest season and rabi harvest season, and the importance of various indicators like health, drinking water, fodder, employment, and migration, and we found out these things. And the recommendation would be the primary problem that we faced, for the first initial 2.5 or 3 days, was gathering the data. And the data was extremely distributed. It was in paper form. It was not in digital form. And we had to talk to different people like ASOs, specifically Assistant Statistical Officer, and APM, and the DRDO also we had to contact because we were not getting help. However, after contacting the DRDO, things started getting better and we were provided with the data. But again, it was irrelevant most of the time. And when we went to the Panchayat village, or the Panchayat office also, there was the only data entry guy, the person was absent. And he had been absent since the last week and the computer wasn't even working. So we were expecting that there might be a centralized database or something so that we might have consistent data, not redundant, and we could be absolutely sure about the data being right. But that was not the case.
As a part of today's visit, I visited Takalapalli village, which is on Rangareddy district. During my village visit, I really find very warm welcoming, and I can see, although Telangana recently formed state, yet all the projects, since compared to Andhra Pradesh, Telangana is a water scarce state, yet there are schemes like Mission Kakatiya and Mission Bhagiratha, which are in a very fast pace, I can say. So that to give the every household water and all, government is working really nice.
I am from a village myself, so it was a good experience for many of us who have not seen villages, and it was a new experience for me also because I have not been to any south village also. Yeah, and Yeah, when compared to North Indian villages also, these are, as my colleagues also said, women empowerment is far, far better than as in North. In North, there's social health is of the society is not that up to the mark, and here I've encountered some economic status. So there are challenges in North India also, and here also there are different challenges. But as of the experience, and I went to Khammam district, Lakshmipuram. So people are very their hospitality is commendable here, and the language is a barrier. But if you have a translator, then it goes smoothly. Yeah. And what I actually experienced in the villages is government schemes, what we face in North India, only the beneficiaries are the process, the people involved in the process are more here, because the government is reaching to the deeper sections also, like SC communities and ST communities. They are more focused on these communities. As in North India, only some part of the village or some part of people are involved in these, and others don't even bother about what's going on actually here. And also the state government schemes, they are complementary to the central government schemes here. As what I experienced in Lakshmipuram, our village was not in the Gram Swaraj Abhiyan. That was our main focus. But the village didn't even need that Gram Swaraj Abhiyan. For example, for Ujwala scheme, it was already under Deepam scheme. And for Ujala scheme also, there was a scheme of Telangana government LED distribution. So yeah, and actually the Gram Swaraj Abhiyan is not applicable to our mandal, but still the schemes are pan India. So at some level they don't know about Pradhan Mantri Jandan Bima Yojana and Pradhan Mantri Jandan Yojana. So but they know about zero balance accounts. So that's actually the same thing, but in different names. So there's awareness issue, but they are having this benefits, and there are beneficiaries actually, and sometimes there are grievances also. And the main problem what we faced is there are lack of funds here, and that's all right on government's behalf, and they have focused on these schemes, and they are well, very well thought schemes.
I would say I was blessed in a way that I was planted in a remote village, because most of the people were posted a model village. Mine was a remote village. It was in Mehboob Nagar, if you know, Madal Bidu. So it was a remote village with a population of around 2000. One thing I gained from there, they say there are same things in life which are routine for us, like fetching a bread or fetching something. It's, or if you just need food, just call Zomato or call anyway. But that things for the village people are a kind of struggle. For all my life, I have lived in Delhi or Chandigarh, but I have experienced this life for the first time. I can really feel the pain of that people, that you have to leave your school after 5th or 6th and you have to go or walk around 5 to 6 kilometers just to have that formal education. So it was a eye-opener for me. I started realizing the importance of things. I used to waste a lot of money because I have come from a good background, so money wasn't that a big money. But I've seen people in the village, so 100 rupees and 500 rupees was such a big amount for them. I realized it made me feel tired one or two moments. Even while coming back, we handed over around amount 7500 or 8. We just distributed among the people. But that no 500 note was such a big thing for them, and for us it was just a Domino's pizza on any other day. So it was a good experience, kind of an eye opener. And Telangana people, I love one thing about them, they love their state very much. So it's been a good experience, and I would like to have that experience for a longer period of time so that I get to know the things better. One thing more, me and my class teammate, there was a girl in the village, Samira, Muslim girl. She was very talented. She was just 14, but I haven't seen a talented girl like that. But she had very scarce resources. So we are planning on adopting her for education, and we'll if everything goes well, we will do it in the future, for sure.
When content overtakes the analysis and observations, this is what happens. So much of work done, but if the first 3% take all the time that is given to the group, then in the team, are we doing justice to the next two presenters? Are we aware of that? Are we sensitive to that? And the last colleague, who is probably has to give some and substance of what is there, summation of all that you have done, he is not only to rush through, he has to virtually close the whole thing. When you make team presentations, doing so group work, be aware that initially the temptation of speaking ready-made content, which three of you did, ready-made content was available. Nothing much was required. Simply statistics were given. But as we progressed, the analysis, the observations, the summations, they were did not get the attention which they deserved. It's a part of the learning process. Be aware and be sensitive to this.
Well, first of all, for any mechanism to function in the whole government hierarchy, the most important part is the political leadership and will. And your chief minister, the chief minister of this very young state, but I won't call it young, it is so advanced, is so progressive, and that percolates down to the lowest level. You know, whatever the kind of governance or I should term it as politics, the governance models that we see, people are so inspired by KCR. If you ask any, even if you question a layman, all he has to say is our CM is so progressive. So overall, it is a very good experience. I think more than experience, it is something which I should take back to the northern part of India. And inarguably, whether it was undivided Andhra Pradesh, and I must at the same time, you know, acknowledge Shri Chandrababu Naidu as well. These two states are, and specifically we are in Telangana. Whenever we friends discuss what is the single most important thing that is propelling Telangana forward, I think it is the political will. And obviously, if there is the political will, all the administrative structures and all the bureaucrats, every functionary, you know, just falls in place. And at the same time, because of these two things, the people feel empowered, because obviously education, health and provision of all the services, all the functions are there, everything falls in place. I think this is the perfect combination anyone can see in the entire country.
Well, the primary difference has always been that state government schemes have always been better implemented than central government. It's easier for somebody to sit in Delhi in an AC room and just pass some bill and say that, okay, this is what it's going to be. But when it's somebody who's state government who takes on the responsibility, and then the again decentralization of power coming up to the Panchayat Raj, and you see some leader supposing like Mr. Rajamouli, who was the vice sarpanch that time. And of course, you do have a rubber stamp sarpanch who we did not interact much with, but possibly because of language barrier. And ultimately, when you come to a village, it all seems the same, because everybody has the core problems. Everybody has the same kind of hope in the government. And despite whatever that happens, whatever the leakages and everything that take place, they still have that hope that sustains throughout the years. No matter how many government changes, they've still got that hope that there's one day there's going to be Achhe Din.
Coming to the demography of the village, the total population of the village was 1,084, and the major population, the major component was constituted by the backward classes, it is 1,032. So according to the figures, you can see that females are more than the male members. So this was the one thing we observed everywhere. The major achievements of the village are here listed. First of all, the village is 100% liquor free. There is no selling of alcohol in the village since the year 1982. So, and for two complete terms, the village had a complete Mahila Panchayat. So it is also a big achievement for the village. So then coming to the use of latrines and toilets, it has been open defecation free since 2003. So everywhere in the village, in every household, there are working functional toilets. So coming to the literacy, it is 100% literate. and all the families are using purified water since 2004.
Ujala scheme, actually our village was not enrolled under the Ujala scheme. So again, the LEDs, they were not provided at the subsidized rate, but still we found some LEDs inside the houses of the people, but very few people were having them. Then we have the PM Jan Dhan Yojana scheme. Actually, the when we went to the houses of the people and we asked them if they are having Jan Dhan accounts, very few people were able to understand it. So, but when I asked them about the zero balance account, they were able to understand it. So there were accounts, and in fact we find out that about 74% Jan Dhan accounts are there in the village. In fact, some houses were having two accounts. They were having savings account as well as the Jan Dhan accounts.
Aarogya Lakshmi, जैसा कि नाम बताता है, ये स्कीम बेसिकली प्रेग्नेंट वुमेन एंड लैक्टेटिंग जो मदर्स हैं एंड चिल्ड्रन, उन लोगों के लिए है. इस स्कीम के अंदर एक फुल मील प्रोवाइड करा जाता है इन सबको. एंड इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द मील, देन प्रेग्नेंट एंड लैक्टेटिंग मदर गेट 1 egg एंड 200 ml ऑफ मिल्क फॉर 25 days इन अ मंथ. एंड इफ आई टॉक अबाउट चिल्ड्रन, देन 7 months to 3 years आर फेडेड विद 16 eggs अ मंथ, एंड 3 years to 6 years आर फेडेड 1 egg अ डे. And during our door-to-door survey, when we conducted in form of a team, then we also met with one lactating mother named as Kamla. She also told us about the scheme.
The fine-tuning of existing processes, changing of non-desirable processes and structures, these things take time. So as when you step into the government, you have to be cognizant of this reality, and every effort that you put in, there should be a long-term vision for that. Whether I am as assistant section officer today or whatever capacity I'm in, I think what matters is the vision post, say like 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, and you know, the entire governance structure, entire bureaucracy is so huge and so vast. You can't say that I'll bring this change, and it won't be very easy. You'll have to sustain, you'll have to persist, and you'll have to work hard, because you'll put in 10 steps, it might be the case that 9 steps backfire, but you'll have to persist in the end.
It was actually the fact that somebody has actually gone out there and conducted a survey and realized that these are the problem areas and this is how we can target them. It is commendable that somebody could actually be the mastermind behind that. Because if whatever we understood from the KCR, our interaction with Dr. Saujanya, we understood that the KCR kit scheme has increased institutionalized delivery. And furthermore, they're opting for natural birth. And another thing that they mentioned, that family planning that was carried out in Ganga Devi Pali, normally you would notice that women are okay to be undergoing a tubectomy, whereas the men are, they want to preserve that sense of masculinity and they would not go for a vasectomy. But here it's actually inverse. And the whole matriarchal structure of the village here, it for me as a woman, it feels really, really empowering, and it feels like you are a part of a society, because otherwise overall you are a part of the patriarchal structure. But when you come here and you realize that women are the driving force, so that's when you know you have this whole stri shakti and everything. It just makes you realize that yeah, it is there, and it's probably a driving force that cannot be suppressed in any way.
Actually, I have never been to a village in my own state. This is the first time I have visited a village. So basically, I cannot compare because I'm not that much versed with that villages in my own state. So, but it was, as it is a model town, a model village, Ganga Devi Palli. So it was very nice experience. I don't know. But the major thing we observed here, there was no caste discrimination. There was no community-based discrimination. All people were together. They standed united. In contrary to the northern states, I can say of Rajasthan, there is a much caste-based discrimination prevailing in villages. Untouchability is also prevailing in some of the villages in North India. So this was the major difference I observed in the village of Ganga Devi Palli.
जब हम गांव में गए तो सबसे प्लस पॉइंट वहां का ये रहा कि वहां के लोगों में 100% साक्षरता रही है. तो जब हम गांव विजिट कर रहे थे तो हम वहां पे एक सरकारी स्कूल है, तो जब हम वहां पे गए तो सबसे पहले हमने देखा कि जो स्कूल की जो बिल्डिंग है वो पूर्णतः अच्छी कंडीशन में है, एंड उसके चारों तरफ बाउंड्री भी है. स्कूल प्राइमरी एंड हाई स्कूल दो भागों में है. स्कूल दो मंजिला इमारत से बनी हुई है, जिसमें प्राइमरी स्कूल में 96 स्टूडेंट हैं एवं हाई स्कूल में 125 स्टूडेंट हैं।
एजुकेशन सिस्टम दैट इज बीइंग वर्किंग इन गंगा देवी पल्ली विलेज एंड द सिस्टम इज वर्किंग वेरी एफिशिएंटली। स्टिल द स्टूडेंट्स आर वेरी टैलेंटेड एंड ऑल्सो वेरी वेल वर्स्ड इन इंग्लिश। स्टिल देर वर फ्यू लिमिटेशंस दैट वी एनकाउंटर्ड ड्यूरिंग आवर इंटरेक्शन विद द स्कूल स्टाफ। First is there is insufficiencies in number of teaching staff. Only two permanent teachers are there and four deputy teachers. And the physical education training teaching post is also not been sanctioned yet, as physical education is very important for overall development of a child. And there is no source of drinking water available in the school building itself. They get water from water cans from ATW, that is anytime water facility, and which is very far from the school. And this problem is more prevailing in the summer. So, and there the school is also lacking in infrastructure also. There is only one single computer available in the school. And although the uniform is provided up to class 8th, there is no provision of uniform for classes 9 and 10.
We started with the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan and we had a few photographs, and which was primarily not needed considering that the village in itself was very clean. Because you would see in the morning, you would see that every individual would come outside their household and whatever cow dung cakes that were there, they would pick it up on their own. So there was no need for implementing any such thing because it was self-initiated. So they also have a lot of these we call them radies, but these tricycles were donated by Moksharamam, which is an NGO, and it collects all the waste, primarily the wet waste, and it puts it in the dumping yard, which is located outside the village.
Before coming over here, I had read in the newspapers that the administration of Telangana is very good as compared to the other states. But now I have personally experienced this thing even in Hyderabad, and even during the village visit, the schemes are very well and they are very much people-centric.
Telangana is really a water scarcity state. We, in such a scarcity, government is working really hard to get the water to each and every household. That's what really a major achievement if it is getting like this. Within the short span of time, it's doing a wonderful part of job.
Quite surprising that a newly state formed as escalating to these new heights, because I should not say this, but I know Telangana was formed because of the economic backwardness. But what I've experienced, it's like if economic backwardness is the main thing to get bifurcated, then North India would have like 20s or 30s of states itself. Because yeah, they are well equipped, I must say that.
Before coming to Telangana, I was aware of many of the schemes as I had fond of studying. Telangana, I think, came up in 2nd June 2014, if I'm not wrong. So it's been just 4 years. So kind of a child state, but the struggle was pretty long. I think the people started the struggle long back in 1955, I suppose. So it was almost a 60-year struggle. The schemes, I would say, some of the schemes like the Kartike, the water scheme. When I read the scheme at the first, it was announced in around 2016, I suppose. At that time, I was thinking, sitting in Punjab, ki yaar, zyada bada ho gaya, nahi kar payenge. But when I visited, they are trying hard to implement the scheme, and they are getting the results for sure. Another scheme, they announced that they will be giving 3 acre land to each Dalit family. And if you go by the Dalit population of Telangana, that land will sum up to somewhere around 1.5 lakh acre, I suppose. So I am looking forward to that scheme if that can be implemented. Rest, the state as is progressing very well. You know, there's water scarcity problem all over the state, and the state doesn't have so many resources as Punjab has. But I've seen, so Punjab is a socialist state, you don't have problem. You have different shape of problems there, but Telangana is really tackling the problem very well. Even the financial state of this Telangana is pretty well if we compare to Punjab. Punjab is kind of financially deficient. So I wish Telangana goes right away and be a model state for other states.
What can constitute the Gram Swaraj as such in your opinion, having gone to
the... So I would say that as the constitution says, we the people, it's always the people who start the change. So the fact that they were united, that they wanted to make that change, they got the change.